Informational graphics have been proven to help you educate your homeowner and close more sales. Hello, I'm Todd Liles, and I'm here with a wonderful tool for you today that's designed to help you educate your homeowner as to the importance of GFCI's ground fault circuit interrupters inside the home. The power of informational graphics is the following. People remember 20% of what they hear, 30% of what they see, but a whopping 50% of what they both hear and see. And that is going to be the power of this amazing tool that you can use that's going to help educate your homeowner. Now, what I'm going to do in this video is I'm going to very simply show you how to use it in the field. And that's one of the things that's nice about these tools is that it requires very little explanation for the homeowner to understand the major components and the major points. Let's begin. We're going to start with the heading, GFCI, what you need to know. Obviously, that is very attention getting. Your homeowner's eyes are going to be drawn to that and they're going to want to read that. The first line is what you don't know can cost you. A home without GFCI, ground fault circuit interrupters, can be deadly. These facts come from the Consumer Product Safety Commission and the Ohio State University. The thing that I want to point out here is that these facts are all third party, which gives you a third party reference point when it comes to where this information is coming from. That adds credibility to you. Now let's transition. The first section is an area of education. Again, all the information that you see here is coming from third-party sources. So the first graph that we're going to look at is this one that covers electrocutions. So over a 10-year study, and you can feel free to look that study up on your own, but over a 10-year study, what was found is that there is an average of 92 deaths per year that's caused by electrocution where there is no GFI present. The study shows that GFCIs are proven to be 81% to 95% effective at preventing the loss of life. Now, what that equates to is somewhere between 75 to 88 deaths per year that could have been avoided had GFCIs been in place. So in the graph here, we show 82 deaths per year. That's meeting right in the middle between 75 to 88, but feel free to explain that the range does show between 75 to 88 deaths per year could have been prevented. Now, obviously, that still leaves a small section where prevention was still not going to occur, but the way that I see it, and I think the way most homeowners would see it, is 81 to 95% protection is far better than no protection. Now, the next section here is the required locations. And what this section is designed to do is to stimulate the knowledge for the homeowner that even though GFCIs have been known to be an amazing protective device for a very long time, there are still a lot of homes today, whether because of age or whether because of poor electrical contractor building or poor service after the fact, for some reason, we still find areas that don't have the proper protection that they should have. So in 1973, the first level of protection became mandatory by the National Electrical Code on new construction for outdoor outlets. In 1975, we added bathrooms. In 1978, garages. In 1990, crawl spaces and unfinished basements. In 1993, wet bars and sinks. And in 2005, laundry rooms and utilities. So this could be a great conversation starter for the homeowner, and it could even lead into the homeowner asking you if you'd do a courtesy inspection of these areas. Now, let's take a look at the importance of GFIs in related to life. This next graph is amazingly visual, and it's going to require just a little bit of explanation if you're unfamiliar with the health effects of amperage on the body. Now, I want to stress again that this information is all third party, and the information that you are seeing here comes particularly from The Ohio State University, a study that they did on the health effects of amperage on the body. So a couple things we want to point out. And what we're going to see is we're going to see that the amperage is going to grow from the bottom up. So somewhere in the range of 0.01 amps and below, it's a very mild sensation. When you get into the range of the graph that you see here at 0.01 amps, working its way to 0.1 amps, you go through the zone of painful shock. You get to the point to where you have muscular gripping. You can't let go of what's causing you the shock. You move into severe shock, and then you can even move into extreme difficulties in breathing. Now, you will notice that in the black, this is a zone that is the death zone. Now, I want to make sure that you understand that's not my terminology. That is straight off of that study. And what it showed is in that study is that in the range of 0.1 amps to 0.2 amps, this is the place where the heart starts having clamping. It's contracting, it's relaxing. And if inside this zone a person stays there for not a very long period of time, this is the area where resuscitation becomes near impossible because of the damage that it causes to the heart. So they refer to this as the death zone. Now, obviously, as you move up, you can still have the death situation occur. But what's interesting is that when greater than 0.2 amps of electricity flows through the body, the heart actually clamps down, and in a strange effect, because it clamps completely down, it has the ability to preserve itself so that resuscitation is possible. Now, you will have breathing. It will stop. You'll have severe burns. And obviously, you can only go through that for so long of a period of time before it becomes a permanent and damaging situation. Now, what's interesting is that GFCIs are designed to stop flow of electricity well before the 0.01 amps of flow takes place. So at most, it's a mild sensation. They do an amazing job of protecting the homeowner from dangerous situations. So here's this wonderful tool for you. Now, what I'd like to do is I'd like to give you a couple ways that you can use it inside of your business today. One is if you're a business owner, feel free to put it on your website. Clients will find this very interesting. Don't be surprised that they don't download it and they read it and then they give you a call. Number two, if you're an electrician in the field, take this, put it inside of your presentation binder. Perhaps early in the call, you simply hand it to them and allow it to do the work. It's one of the great things about it. They will read it. Don't be surprised if they don't ask you for a courtesy inspection. And of course, when you find that a homeowner doesn't have these very important safety devices in their homes, you can use this to educate, build value, and show the homeowner the important need of having these protection devices inside of their home. Well, there you have it. It's yours. It's ready for download. And all you have to do to get access to it is simply put in your name and your email, and you will instantly receive an email that will allow you to download this. We want you to go out there and feel free to use it to help build value and close those very important safety sales for you that will protect your clients. Also, we want you to tell us about your results. As results are coming in, let us know. So that's it. Here's an amazing tool for you, ready to use. And again, you can get yours now by putting in your name and your email.